What's up, everyone? So this screencast is about a compiler extension. I know it's a bit strange to have a screencast dedicated to a compiler extension, but just bear with me because it's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to talk about Declspec Property, which, as you may have guessed, it introduces support for properties inside C++. Now, for those of you who think that compiler extensions are evil, I think you should just leave, switch off the screencast or switch off YouTube, go outside for a walk, and then, you know, come back and watch this again if you change your mind. But for those of you who are interested, let's take a look at what this actually does. So essentially, the problem is very simple. The problem is, well, what if you want to have a byproduct of some value being represented as a property rather than as a function? So a typical case is something like this. So if I have a class called person, then if a person has an age, then they can also vote. So if you're a C++ developer, you would write something like bool can vote as a function, and you would return age greater than or equal to 16, for example. So this feels natural to maybe a C++ developer or a Java developer. It's totally unnatural to a .NET developer because can vote is not a function. I'm sorry, but functions are used to represent behavior, and an ability to vote is not a behavior. It's an ability. It's a trait. So essentially, it should be either a field or indeed a property if your language supports it. Unfortunately, C++ does not support properties. Inherently, there is no first class support. There is no language feature for properties. However, with this Declspec property business, you can actually get the property. You can actually get something to behave as a property. So how does this work? Well, essentially, let's get rid of this for now. What you do with this Declspec property is you write it like this, Declspec property. So this is a property which is of type bool, and it's called canVote. And inside here, what you have to do is you have to specify the getters and the setters for the property. So for example, the getter might be get can vote. And then of course, you need to specify a function which calculates exactly the same thing. So you have get can vote, and we implement it in a similar fashion. So return age greater than or equal to 16. So here is our function, and the end result, like what you get out of it all, is an ability to treat a property as a property as opposed to as a function. So you write person P, and then you give P an age like 22, and then you can actually output whether they can vote by using p.canVote. Notice there is no round braces here. It's just p can vote, like so. So the question is, well, is it really worth it? And there are benefits and disadvantages to this. The first disadvantage is, unfortunately, you don't get encapsulation, meaning I would love to be able to take this getter and stick it into the private section. But unfortunately, if I try to build this thing, let's try to compile it, we're going to get an error, regrettably. And the reason we're going to get this here we go. It's a definition that's inaccessible, because canVote is simply kind of a placeholder or a redirection. So when we call canVote, we're essentially calling getCanVote directly, and it's private. And we are not allowed to call something that's private. So unfortunately, in terms of encapsulation, it's not such a good thing, regrettably. And also, you have to realize that if you have some other property that is not read-only, like let's suppose you have the name, and then you have Declspec property where you have both the getter and the setter. So you get equals get name, and put equals put name, and that's string name with a capital N, and you make the getters and setters, you are not able to stick the name inside the private section as well. So in terms of encapsulation, you're not really getting anything. So I just had to tell you this, because otherwise people would complain and say, well, if this is a property, then why are you exposing the actual functions? Can we please get rid of the functions? Well, the answer is no, you cannot. So it's not such a great thing. However, something very useful that you can do with all of this is change notification, which is once again a kind of central feature in .NET, and in C++, people get around it in various ways, and those ways are not always great, and they always revert around this idea of signals and slots. And indeed, this is what you have to use if you're a C++ developer, because as I said, there is nothing else in the language to help you in this regard, unfortunately. So let me show you how change notification works. Let's suppose, for example, that you have a person and they have an age. So they have, like, the person is so many years old, and then they get older, and you want notification of when somebody gets older, maybe because it's tied to some part of the user interface, or I don't know, but you want to be notified. And because there are no events in C++, you end up having to use signals and slots. So here, what I'm doing is I'm using signals to from boost. And that lets me effectively have a notification mechanism. So we're going to copy .NET here. What we're going to do is we'll make a new class, type name T class, and I'm going to call it INotifyPropertyChanged, simply because this is what it's called in .NET. And we're totally stealing the idea here. So essentially we have a signal. So whenever somebody gets older or their age changes to whatever value, we call a function. So we provide a function to be called, and that function can have like a pointer to the person whose age has been changed, and can also specify the name of the field that's been changed. It can also have the value. For example, I'm going to get rid of the value here because that's one of the things that you would have issues with, and here you would have to have boost any, but I'm not going to go there for this little demo. So anyways, this is a signal that's going to be invoked when somebody's age actually does change. So we're going to call this property changed. And what happens now is in class person, we effectively inherit this mechanism. So we inherit the I here, stands for interface. Of course, C++ does not have interfaces either, so it's simply a class with a field that we're inheriting, but that's okay. This isn't particularly a problem. So we need to specify the original class as the template. So the template argument is the original class. All right, so now what's happening, and IntelliSense. Well, now what's happening is anytime we want, we can fire off a signal, and somebody can be listening to that signal. So let's go with this idea of having an age that we can change. So I'm going to have getters and setters. So I'm going to have get age defined as return age, and that's not very interesting, is it? But the setter is going to be interesting. So we're going to have a function called putAge. I don't know why the word put is being used instead of set, but that's the way things are. At least, well, you can name the function anything you want, obviously, but in the in Declspec property, you have to use put. We'll see it in a second. So essentially what we do here is, first of all, we check that the value is different, because the value that's provided value has to be different. So if the value is equal to the current age, we simply return. There's nothing to do. There is no update notification that needs to be done. Nobody needs to assign anything. So now that we're verified this condition, we assign a value. So we say age equals value, and then we fire the signal. So here is the signal. It takes two arguments. It takes a pointer to the current object and the name of the property that we're modifying. That's property, not field. And notice once again, there is no way to protect age with a small a. So what we're doing is we're calling property changed, and we're providing a pointer to the current object and also the name. So in this case, the name can be age with a capital A. All right, so now we need a Declspec property. Here we go, Declspec property. So get the getter is get underscore age, and the setter is put underscore age, and it's of type int, and it's going to be called age with a capital A. So let's see how this actually works, and because we obviously want to subscribe to the change notifications on the person. So let's make person P. And then what we need to do, of course, is we need to say P dot property change dot connect. And this is where we subscribe to the event. So when the person's age actually changes, we basically do something. So we have to provide effectively a slot. And the slot is, of course, some kind of function that handles the event. and it takes a pointer, so that's person P, and it takes the name of whatever got changed, so something like this. And here, of course, what we can do is we can actually, what is it complaining? Function get canvote. Oh yes, some old IntelliSense garbage that we're somehow dragging in here. Never mind. So once we handle the event, we can output it. So for example, we can say that person had their age changed, exclamation mark. We don't know what it was changed to. And in fact, instead of age, we can break at this point and put in name, because that's the name of a property that's been changed. So now person, we can actually assign it a few times. So p dot capital age equals 22 p dot capital age plus plus. All right, let's see how this goes. Ta-da, let's build this whole thing. No, it's always the same. No instance of function template, blah, 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 whatever. I hate these messages because they never tell you anything. Okay, so build it somehow. And why am I not getting attached? Probably because the setting is different. Yeah, it should be the console. Oh, it is console. So debug, start debugging, better run. All right, so as you can see, we get person had their age changed twice, because that's what we did. And we can actually get the age because we have a pointer to the actual object. So we can say they had their age changed to, and then the actual age. I might as well use capital. Right, go again. Alrighty, 22, 23. So as you can see, we get change notification in C++, which I think is pretty amazing. So if you hate compiler extensions, then go and cry in a pillow. And if you don't, then provided you're using something like the Intel compiler or the Visual C++ compiler, you can leverage Declspec property, and it might do some good things for you. And that's it for this screencast.